When adding or subtracting unlike fractions, which are fractions that do not have the same number in the denominators, the bottom number of the fractions, and these denominators are large numbers, such as adding 5 over 12 plus 6 over 17 plus 7 over 20, the method of prime numbers for finding the least common denominator or least common multiple can be helpful. And a common denominator is a whole number that can be divided evenly, so no remainder, by the denominators of all the fractions. A prime number is a whole number that can only be divided evenly, so no remainder, by 1 and itself, which are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, and so on. In order to add these fractions, we need to convert the fractions into like fractions, that is, fractions that have the same number in the denominators. To use the method of prime numbers, we first write the three denominators, 12, 17, and 20, as dividends. We're going to start with the smallest prime number of 2 and see if any of the numbers are evenly divisible by 2. Both 12 and 20 are, so we'll put 2 as the divisor, and next, put those quotients above the given dividends as you see here. 12 divided by 2 is 6, and 20 divided by 2 is 10. Since 17 is not evenly divisible by 2, we'll just bring that number up. Next, we're going to put the new quotients of 6, 17, and 10 as the dividends. And again, start with the smallest prime number of 2 and see if any of the numbers are evenly divisible by 2. Both 6 and 10 are. So we'll put 2 as the divisor, and next, just as before, put those quotients above the given dividends, as you see here. 6 divided by 2 is 3, and 10 divided by 2 is 5. Since 17 is not evenly divisible by 2, we'll again just bring that number up. Next, we're going to put the new quotients of 3, 17, and 5 as the dividends. And again, start with the smallest prime number of 2 and see if any of the numbers are evenly divisible by 2. None of the dividends are divisible by 2, so we'll try the next prime number of 3, which the first dividend of 3 is evenly divisible. So we'll put 3 as the divisor and put the new quotient above the given dividend. 3 divided by 3 equals 1, and for the other two dividends, which are not evenly divisible by 3, we again just bring those up to the quotients. Next, we're going to put the new quotients of 1, 17, and 5 as the dividends. And again, start with the smallest prime number of 2 and see if any of the numbers are evenly divisible by 2, which none are. So we check the next prime number of 3. None are evenly divisible by 3, so on to the next prime number of 5. And 5 is evenly divisible by 5. So we put 5 as a divisor and put the new quotient above the given dividend. 5 divided by 5 equals 1. And for the other two dividends, which are not evenly divisible by 5, we again just bring those up to the quotients. Next, we're going to put the new quotients of 1, 17, and 1 as the dividends. And again, start with the smallest prime number of 2 and work our way through the prime numbers. And the first one we come to that can be divided evenly by any of the dividends is 17. So we'll put 17 as the divisor and put the new quotient above the given dividend. 17 divided by 17 equals 1. And for the other two dividends, which are not evenly divisible by 17, we again just bring those up to the quotients. And this is what we're looking for. All ones in the top row is the quotients. So next, we're going to take all the divisors we have on the left and multiply them. So 2 times 2 times 3 times 5 times 17, which gives us our least common denominator of 1,020. If we go back to our beginning fractions, we need to convert them so they all have 1,020 in their denominators. For the first fraction, 5 over 12, in order to get 1,020 in the denominator, we need to know what to multiply the fraction by. So we divide 1,020 by 12 to find this value, which is 85. Next, we need to multiply the numerator of 5 by the same value of 85, which equals 425. So our new fraction is 425 over 1,020. One note, 5 over 12 is the same value as 425 over 1,020. For the second fraction, 6 over 17, in order to get 1,020 in the denominator, we need to know what to multiply the fraction by. So we divide 1,020 by 17 to find this value, which is 60. Next, we need to multiply the numerator of 6 by the same value of 60, which equals 360. So our new fraction is 360 over 1,020. For the third fraction, 7 over 20, in order to get 1,020 in the denominator, we need to know what to multiply the fraction by. So we divide 1,020 by 20 to find this value, which is 51. Next, we need to multiply the numerator of 7 by the same value of 51, which equals 357. So our new fraction is 357 over 1,020. Now we can add the fractions together, and our answer is 1,142 over 1,020. And if you want, you can convert this to a mixed number and reduce the fraction, which is 1 in 61 over 510. Here's another example of this method, adding three fractions together with the steps written out, the conversions, and the addition of the converted fractions. And you can use this same method for subtracting fractions that have larger denominators, as you see here. Again, the steps written out, the conversions, and then the subtraction to get the final answer. All right, my friends, hopefully you got something out of this video. I do have more videos right there for you. Till next time, I am out of here.